A very good evening to all of you and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And today I'm going to show you that how you can create this face changing impression in PowerPoint 2016. So have a look here. As you can see that the character move his head right, then turn his head back to left, and then his eyebrow moves and eye blinks, and also see the mouth impression. So that is what we need to animate in this video. And let me tell you that this animation is truly inspired from Chris Gannon work at codepen.io. And let me tell you one more thing about Codepen, that these guys are really great. They do all these animation using HTML. So if you are interested in HTML or Java kind of scripts, I don't know much about them, but as you can see that he has used HTML, CSS and JS code to create this entire scene and then animating the head of the character. As you can see that only the head of the character is moving here. So that is all we need to animate in PowerPoint. So let's get started here. So let me tell you one thing, that this entire scene has been divided in 3 slides. So this entire impression will be covered in 3 slides. As you can see that is the exact animation in one shot, and that has been completed using 3 slides, not only on one slide, but this entire scene is covering 3 different slides. So if I open the animation pane from the animations tab, then you can see here that on the first slide only 2 animations has been used, and on the second slide these are the list of the animations, and on the third slide again only 1 animation has been used. So when I play the slideshow, then all the 3 slides work simultaneously according to their timings. So first of all, let me delete these 2 slides by selecting the second one and then the third one, then right click on the slide and choose delete slide, and now we only have this first slide. And I will also delete these 2 animations here. And I want to show you the selection pane here, because I will be very happy if you start drawing characters in PowerPoint. As you can see that I have drawn the entire character using the shape tools, and the freeform is one of my favorite tool that I use to create these kind of characters in PowerPoint. And here you can see in the selection pane all the objects that I have used to create this entire scene. Or the most important thing here is that the body and the face is, and the outside circle is middle between both of them. If I move the outside circle to on top of the face, then you can notice that the face will go behind the circle. That is why it is in the middle, because I want the head to be on top of the circle, whereas the body part is behind the circle. If I move it up, then you can see that it will come over the circle. So these are the objects, and here you can see one object here that is called anchor point, and it has been used to rotate the head from a particular direction. Let me show you by turning on the guides from the view menu. And as you can see that when I select the face here, as you can see that the face has been selected in the selection pane, then you can notice that the anchor point of this object is right here. But if I move the head, then you can see that the head is covering only that much of area on the slide, but still the anchor point is right here. That is because there is another hidden object here called anchor point. And if I fill a color, then you can see that it is a circle here. Then I grouped them together to create a custom anchor point. You can watch my video about custom anchor point, and that will be very much helpful you to animate certain things in PowerPoint 2016. So I will animate the head first, and for that, go to the animations tab, click add animation drop down button and choose spin, and set it to play with previous. Set a delay timing of around 2 seconds, because I want this head to animate after 2 seconds, when I turn on the slideshow, and I would like to rotate this head between 15 seconds, 0.15 seconds, sorry, and open the effect options. And I don't want any smoothness and don't want to auto reverse this effect as well, and want to start it with previous with a delay timing of 2 seconds, and I want this head to move quickly, so I give a very little time of 0.15 seconds, and I want to rotate this head to 10 degree clockwise. Hit the OK button, and after 2 seconds it will rotate its head. So if you want to make it slower, then you can also give 0.25 seconds. It's up to you that what timings you want to give to each animation. Now the next thing I will do, I want this head to go back to the left side, and for that again I will use the spin effect with previous with a delay timing of 3.5 second, that is 1.5 second later the first effect will appear, and I want the same duration for this as well, 0.25. Let me show you the slideshow. So after 2 seconds, head moves to right. Sorry, I forget to change the rotation degree, and I want to rotate this second animation to 20 degree counterclockwise. That's it. Now let's see the slideshow again. Okay, that's fine. Now what we need to do, we need to duplicate this slide by right clicking on the first slide, choose duplicate slide, and here you need to ungroup the objects of the face. So select the face and go to the format tab, click group and then ungroup, and you can see that after ungrouping the object, both of the animation has automatically been deleted. So that is because PowerPoint automatically do that. If you have applied animations to certain objects, and if you later group them with any other object, then PowerPoint will remove the animations. So the same has happened here on the second slide. So why I did so? Because I want the eyebrow, the eye and the mouth to animate differently. So in PowerPoint 2016, you can't apply two different animations to a grouped object. So that is why I have to ungroup all of these objects here on the face. And if I show you the selection pane, then you can notice that all these objects has been separated because I want to animate all of them separately. And before ungrouping these objects, so before applying the animation, what you need to do is to, you need to rotate the face to 10 degree counterclockwise. That is because if you see this animation, when the head is on 10 degree left side, at that time the eyebrow, the eye and the mouth animate as you can see here, then it come back to its original position. So I need to rotate this head to 10 degree, and for that right click on the object and choose format shape, go to the size and properties, pull down the size drop down menu, and here apply minus 10 degree here, minus 10 degree, and hit the enter key. And now I will ungroup this face. From the format tab, click group and then click ungroup, and one more time I need to ungroup this face. That's right. Now we will animate rest of the objects, and I need to first apply the animation on the left eye, and for the left eye go to the animation, add animation, apply grow shrink with previous with a duration of 1.5 second, and then open the effect option by double clicking on the effect. And here I need to choose the size, and for the size I will apply 2% only vertical, and hit the OK button. And I also want to auto reverse this effect, and hit the OK button. As you can see, let me show you that again. Okay, and I want to apply the same animation to the right eye. So select the left eye, then click the animation printer, and then click on the right eye. That's fine. And now I will animate the left eyebrow, and for that go to the add animation, choose more motion path, and then choose up motion path, hit the OK button. And now you need to adjust the path size, and I want to move it right here. So select the eyebrow and then zoom in, and you have to do this very carefully. That's right here. Open the effect option. I don't want any smoothness for this, and want to auto reverse this effect with the start with previous and a duration of 0.25 seconds. Let me type that 0.25. Hit the OK button, and I also want 0.25 duration. I would like to animate all of these three after a half second delay. And on the first slide, as you can see that it is ending on 3.8, so I will give the transition timing to this slide 4 seconds. On the second slide, we have applied the three animations, and now see if we see the slideshow from the first slide. Okay, that's fine. And now select the left eyebrow, go to the animation tab, click animation painter, and then click on the right eye. That's fine. Now we need to animate the mouth, and for that I need to copy and paste this mouth and change the size of this mouth and color. I will use the same color as of the nose, so I will use eyedropper and will adjust the size just like that, and will put right it here. So what we need to do to animate the mouth, first we will hide this white mouth, and for that I will apply the disappear effect with previous with a delay timing of 0.75. I just want to blink the mouth after a little delay from the previous animations. Then I want this gray mouth to appear, and for that I apply the appear effect with previous. Okay, and after a little while I want this gray mouth to disappear. After 1 second, I think. Yes, that will be fine. And then I want this mouth, white mouth, to appear again. So I apply the appear with previous. So let's see the slideshow. Okay, 0.75, 0.75. Let me set it to 1. Okay, let's see the slideshow. Yeah, that's fine. Let's see it again. That's totally up to you, that how you want to animate the mouth. If you want to add a little more delay timing here, then you can add it. Let's see the slideshow. Okay, so finally we need the face to turn back to its original position, and for that I will again copy the first slide, make a duplicate of this slide, put it down to the second, and then what you need to do, you need to apply only one single animation here, and I would like to give it a delay timing of just 0.25 seconds. And this time I will say rotate the face to 10 degree clockwise. Hit the OK button and see the slideshow from the first slide. And here we have our final animation. So the head move right, then left, then it animate all the objects of the face, and then reverse back to its original position. So I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by leaving your valuable comments in the section below. Don't forget to hit the like button, and make sure to subscribe our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.